A fast food outlet in South Africa has been ordered to withdraw a commercial showing an African explorer conquering Europe in the 17th century. The advertising board said colonialism was traumatic for Africans and was not open for humorous exploitation. Chicken Licken said the advertisement was tongue-in-cheek and meant to create pride among South Africans. Dutch navigator Jan van Riebeek's arrival in South Africa in 1652 started the country's colonization process. The advert shows a young African, Bigamo Nano, leaving his village in 1650 to conquer his hunger for adventure. His boat finally docks in Holland in 1651, and he says in South African slang, "Hello, white folk, I like this place. I think I will call it you," wrote, before stomping his spear to signal the land's conquest. The commercial ends with an elderly African man in a bow tie leaving a Chicken Licken outlet and saying, "And that is the legend of Big John." South African Sambio Seal lodged a complaint with the advertising regulatory board, arguing that the commercial made a mockery of the struggles of the African people against the colonization by the Europeans in general and the persecutions suffered at the hands of the Dutch in particular. Upholding the complaint, the board said, "While the commercial seeks to turn the colonization story on its head with Big John traveling to Europe, it is well known that many Africans were in fact forced to travel to Europe in the course of the colonization of Africa. They did not leave their countries and villages willfully. They starved to death during those trips to Europe and arrived there under harsh and inhumane conditions." In its submission, Chicken Licken said it was regrettable that the advertisement had been construed as negative, as it was intended to show that South Africa had all the potential to conquer the world and rewrite history from an African perspective. On Twitter, many people tended to agree with the fast food chain. "But we did bring civilization to Europe. The moor is why is this offensive?" Chicken Licken's Big John advert has been banned because it makes a notary of the struggle against colonialism. https://tcobsf2fr.k End of Twitter post by @WesleyPepper. South Africa the banned Chicken Licken at Why David, it's hilarious and witty. People need to get a grip and get on with life. Seriously, https://tcobqpv End of Twitter post by @frognotboil. I liked it. I actually thought the ad was mocking how people thought they found South Africa in 1652. Chicken Licken. End of Twitter post by @dugnado. Classic. Loved it. Chicken Licken are not stupid. They could not buy that amount of publicity. Now, if they were really smart, they would have got someone to complain about it. Just the same. End of Twitter post by @braveday99. A poacher has been ordered to watch the Disney film Bambi repeatedly after he was convicted of illegally killing hundreds of deer. Missouri hunter David Barry must view the film at least once a month during his year-long sentence. He was arrested in August, along with two family members, for killing the deer, taking their heads and leaving their bodies to rot. Prosecutors said, "It is reportedly one of the biggest poaching cases in Missouri history." On top of the jail sentence for the illegal deer hunting, Judge Robert George ordered Barry Jenner to view the Walt Disney movie Bambi, with the first viewing being on or before December 23, 2018, and at least one such viewing each month thereafter. During his spell in prison, the 1942 cartoon about woodland creatures shows a hunter kill the mother of eponymous deer character Bambi. A months-long investigation spanning several states led to the arrest of Barry Jr., his father David Barry Sr., and his brother Kyle Barry, according to a local newspaper. the Springfield newsletter. While the total number of deer taken illegally is unknown, Lawrence County is conservation agent, and Bibon said it could be several hundred. Barry Jenner received a year-long sentence in Lawrence County prison after pleading guilt to illegally taking wildlife. He has also been sentenced to a subtracted a term in Barton County prison for a firearms probation violation. And both he and his father had their hunting privileges revoked for life by the Missouri Conservation Commission. Two Scandinavian women tourists have been found dead in Morocco with the cats to their necks, the country's interior ministry said. Both bodies were found near the town of Inro, in the High Atlas mountain range, near the foot of North Africa's highest peak, Mount Abko. The women, from Denmark and Norway respectively, have not yet been named. A police investigation has been launched into their deaths, the Interior Ministry statement said. The US military says it has killed 62 fighters from the Islamist group Al-Shabaab in 6 airstrikes in Somalia. 4 airstrikes on Saturday killed 32 militants, and a further 2 on Sunday killed 28, it said in a statement. These were the deadliest air attacks in Somalia since November 2017, when the United States said it had killed 100 militants. Somalia has seen a sharp increase in the number of airstrikes and casualties since President Donald Trump took office in the US in January 2017. A tally by the Bureau of Investigative Journalism reveals that at least 400 people have been killed in airstrikes since the beginning of 2017, far more than the previous 10 years combined. The latest strikes bring to at least 40 the number carried out in Somalia so far this year, compared with 35 recorded in 2017. The United States has a huge military base in neighboring Djibouti, from where it launches attacks on the militants. Mr. Trump gave the United States military greater authority in March 2017 to attack militants in Somalia. Traditionally, United States presidents have been wary of intervening in Somalia since 18 Special Forces soldiers died fighting militias in the capital Mogadishu in 1993, a battle dramatized in the film Black Hawk Down. No civilians were killed in the latest air strikes, which were carried out in coordination with the Somali government, the United States military said. Alongside our Somali and international partners, we are committed to preventing Al-Shabaab from taking advantage of safe havens from which they can build capacity and attack the people of Somalia. The United States Africa Command said Al-Shabaab, which is linked to Al-Qaeda, has not yet commented on the latest strikes. Somalia-based security think tank the Herald Institute said, in a report published in November, that Al-Shabaab had been forced to change tactics following the upsurge in airstrikes. The institute said the group was now conducting fewer mass attacks on military bases, but attacks on government offices and businesses, which refused to pay its taxes, had increased markedly. The US State Department, in its most recent report on terrorism, described Somalia as a terrorist safe haven and said Al-Shabaab remained a threat despite suffering setbacks. The group retained control over large parts of the country and the ability to carry out high-profile attacks using suicide bombers, explosive devices, mortars, and small arms. The report added, the United States military says it has killed 62 fighters from the Islamist group Al-Shabaab in 6 airstrikes in Somalia. 5 airstrikes on Saturday killed 32 militants, and a further 2 on Sunday killed 28, it said in a statement. These were the deadliest air attacks in Somalia since November 2017, when the United States said it had killed 100 militants. Somalia has seen a sharp increase in the number of airstrikes and casualties since President Donald Trump took office in the US in January 2017. A tally by the Bureau of Investigative Journalism reveals that at least 400 people have been killed in airstrikes since the beginning of 2017, far more than the previous 10 years combined. The latest strikes bring to at least 40 the number carried out in Somalia so far this year, compared with 35 recorded in 2017. The United States has a huge military base in neighboring Djibouti, from where it launches attacks on the militants. Mr. Trump gave the United States military greater authority in March 20, 2017 to attack militants in Somalia.